and Ascend Ping Equus in front from Dark Before Dawn, Watford Town, Dawn Magic, Ember Lane, the Red Dawn, Miss Molly May at the furlong, and Enping Equus is still leading and kicking. It's Enping Equus in front inside the half. Dark Before Dawn lunges near the line, takes the lead, and Dark Before Dawn wins.
So welcome to day two of week three. Then a thrilling win there for John Morgan's Dark Before Dawn in yesterday's 1,000 guineas. And let's hope that today's 2,000 guineas, which is today's feature race out of the four meetings we've got at Thirsk, Newmarket, Ascot and Musselburgh. Today's feature race, of course, is the Colts version. It's the 2,000 guineas. And if we get anywhere near as good a race today as we had yesterday, then it should be something to really look forward to. And I'll be looking forward to calling that one home a little bit later on in the day. The support races at Newmarket today are the Pearl Palace House Stakes over 5 furlongs and the Mafke Suffolk Stakes over 9 furlongs. Before that, though, we've got two races from Thirsk, one of which is the Topal.com Thirsk Hunt Cup over a mile. And then later on, we've got some races at Ascot and Musselburgh, the Longines Cigarro Stakes over 2 miles at Ascot and the Topal.com Rural Mile over a mile at Musselburgh being the main two. So earlier then in the week, I had a little chat with Doug and Stu about what we thought might happen today. We didn't do particularly well yesterday, did we? But let's see if we can do a little bit better today, shall we? Okay, so great first classic of the season yesterday with the 1,000 guineas, and today it's the 2,000 guineas at Newmarket. This one's for the Colts, of course, and I've got another great big field for this. What are we like to look of this time, Doug?
Okay, I've had a quick squeeze through the field, and I'm going to go with Tuk Tuk for John Morgan.
Okay.
He's obviously got it in the Thailand or somewhere with the old Tuk Tuk. But then again, that Tuk Tuk's here's got three wheels, so maybe this horse has got three legs.
If I had to pick one, again, very hard. I mean, like you say, the top lot is, what, £5 between the first six or seven it is, you know, in the rating. So, I mean, they're all pretty much the much of a muchness. Very hard to pick one, but let's see who I should give the kiss of death to. Anyway, I'm going to go for Lord Law for Stephen Rann.
It's an interesting looking race again, isn't it? Because there's only the top one, John Morgan's, that's unbeaten. And, you know, I like to go for unbeaten horses, but he says it's a 7 furlong horse. And I need to be able to stay a mile to win this race. And I just got a feeling that Paul Rhodes can't continue to be as sort of off the mark and unlucky as he has been so far this season. And I know he targets these big races, these classics. He'd rather win, if he only had 3 or 4 winners a season, he'd want them to be the classics and then forget the rest. So I'm going to go for Paraglider.
Okay, which is his lower rated one, isn't it? Or is that his higher rated one? Oh, yes, higher rated one. I was down at the bottom, you're quite right.
Yeah, I mean, he's got to turn the full round on the two that beat it last week. But you know what this game's been like this season? I mean, nothing has put together two wins yet, has it? I haven't got remember seeing anything that's won 2 weeks on the trot.
I don't know, actually, now you've said that. I have not noticed, but then I might not have taken much notice. But yeah, you're probably right. I don't think, certainly not on the flat, I don't think we've seen two wins. We might have had a couple of winners over the hump. I think I might just be...
It does seem to be wide open. It seems to be wide open. And of course, with this as well, it's the draw, which we don't know yet, is going to make a big difference. Because if you're on the side that's got the pace, then that might help. And you've got a couple of Django horses in there. They tend to go off pretty quick, a lot of them. And there's a Hans one right down the bottom, which is only rated 45, called Heist. Now, I know the way that Hans does things, I'm pretty sure he might want to put that one in there as a pacemaker for his other one. So that could go off really quick, and
interesting.
It could be a funny race. We've had some funny results in this race over the last few seasons, and wide open. So I'm
sure we'll see.
We'll see what happens. So just to recap, then Paraglider for me,
and where am I? Tuk Tuk for me,
and Lord Law for me.
So there's three horses to cross off the potential list of winners of the 2,000 guineas. Then apologies to all the trainers involved for our selections. And we'll get on with today's racing, shall we? I shall be doing the first two at Thirsk and the first four at Newmarket, including that 2,000 guineas. And then Tim Sandyman will be taking over for the second part of the day with the final race at Newmarket and the races at Ascot and Musselburgh.